Thank you very much. Now, I always like to take my audience on a little journey back in time whenever I do a show, and tonight is no exception. I love nothing better than reading the old magic books, looking for inspiration. And one of my favorite magic books is called The Secrets of Conjuring and Magic by Robert Houdin. It was published in 1868. Think about that, it was 200 years. And there was a beautiful chapter in the book where he talks about the experience of magic. And he actually says, and I'm quoting now, "There's no finer mystery in magic than a playing card neatly changed." And he goes on to explore this possibility for a magician to hold the playing card in his hand and it transforms into another one while the audience is staring at it. Think about that as a concept for a moment. If you could actually experience that, what kind of impact would that have on you? Sophie?
Awestruck.
I can deal with awestruck. And if we could have an awestruck experience right now on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you give that?
11.
11, excellent. Out of 10, that's really pushing the envelope now. I'm going to ask you to shuffle the cards, okay? Get the cards. Oh, wait a minute, you've had that experience already. Well, I tell you, I saw how you do it, so I'm going to give you a bunch. You get a bunch. And we do the old mishmash. Is that how you did it on the table earlier? Was it more comfortable for you? See, Chris, I was paying attention. All right, a little old shuffle, shuffle, mix, mix. Okay, a few cuts, whatever works best for you, then hand them back to me one at a time. I always like to work with a shuffle deck in use so that there is no cheating, no trickery. And I want to work with this gentleman just behind you. Okay, sir, I know you've been watching rather intently. The cards have been well mixed by my able crew. All right. So, you know what, rather than take one, let's just do this nice and random. As I release them with my thumb, you'll tell me stop, okay? Okay. Here we go.
Oh, stop.
Did I stop right where you told me to?
Yeah.
Right there. That's for you. Look at it. Remember it. Show it to everyone. Splendid. Excellent. And will you tell me stop again? Okay.
Stop.
Right here. Okay. Pop that back for us. Excellent. Tell me, how far down would you say that is, give or take? Just beyond half, I would estimate.
Yeah.
The whole point is I'm not going to shuffle the cards. Exactly as the Grandmaster said, to be able to take a playing card, a five of diamonds, and just by shaking it, make it change into another card. Would that be interesting?
Mm-hmm.
We're going for an awestruck moment of magic right now. But you know, I better adjust my glasses. I want to see this myself. Look at this. What was your card?
Seven of spades.
Did we make it? Unfortunately, we live in a world where people don't believe in magic, but if we feel it hard enough, we can have that experience and be right back where we started. Now, this got me thinking, would it be possible to do it 3 times, 4 times in a row? I'm a bit of a daredevil. Let's go for it, shall we? These cards have been well shuffled. I'm going to choose a few people on this side of the audience. Sir, would you like to help? I'm going to spread the card, just tell me stop. We remember that card?
Yep.
Don't forget it. You'll see it in a moment, okay? And how about this gentleman right here? Sir, would you like to say stop?
Stop.
Okay, this one's for you. Yep. And the nice thing is you both stopped at 2 random positions inside the deck. Okay, and I'm hoping 2 different cards. Let me come over to this side. Would you like to say stop?
Stop.
This one's for you. Got it? And if I remember correctly, your name, Thierry?
Yeah.
Good name. Say stop.
This
one's for you. We got it? Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, 4 cards, 4 random positions in the pack. I think this will be interesting. We are going back in time. Because when Robert Houdin stood on the stage and attempted to find all the cards by looking through the pack, he figured it's a waste of time. Let's cause a transformation. Touch one. 2 of diamonds. Watch this. You were first, sir. Would you mind standing right here, sir? Watch this. I don't believe the 2 of diamonds was your card.
No.
Is that correct? Are you right or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Watch closely, everyone. Hold your hand up. Concentrate on your card and cast a spell over them. What was the name of your card? get it. So, I'm going to hand this to you. Put your other hand on top. Concentrate on your card. What was it?
Six of clubs.
Take a look. You get it? Oh my goodness. The six of clubs. Come on up. Whoa, careful. You didn't choose the six of clubs, did you?
No.
Hold your hand out for me. Splendid. Can you hold that for me? Place your other hand on top. Concentrate. What was your card?
Eight of spades.
Take a look. Oh, the eight of spades. Thank you so much. And Sherry, I believe you are next. Can you just hold that eight of spades? You didn't choose the eight of spades, did you? Concentrate on your card. Which one was it?
King of diamonds.
Take a look. Oh my goodness, that is a quadruple combination. And you chose the two of diamonds. Just blow a kiss for me. Beautifully done. Right back.